Go forth, O monks, for the good of the many, for the happiness of the many, out of compassion for the world, for the good, for the benefit, and for the happiness of both gods and men. These inspiring words influenced many throughout the annals of Buddhist history. In the 20th century, there were very few people who knew about the Buddha and his teachings in its birthplace, India. Mahabodhi Society was founded in 1891 by Venerable Anagarika Dhammapala. He was a great missionary with a vision to restore the holy places related to the Buddha. Enthused by the Buddha's words, one more monk with profound love and compassion vowed to devote his life for the revival of Buddhism in India. He is none other than Venerable Acharya Buddharakkhita, the founder president of Mahabodhi Society, Bangalore. In search of the meaning and purpose of human life, as a wandering ascetic, Satyapriya, the Bible, the Quran, the Gita, and the Dhammapada were his constant companions, apart from learning and meeting eminent gurus of his time. While meditating under Sri Ramana Maharshi in Tiruvannamalai, he realized that for a very long time he has been pursuing the Buddhist path. He just needed to pick up the thread where he had left. It was a turning point in the life of young Rabindra. In 1949, Vaishakha full moon, in the serene surroundings of Kushinagar, Satyapriya got his ordination as a Buddhist monk from a very compassionate monk, Most Venerable Chandramuni Mahathera of Burma. And thus Satyapriya became Buddharakkhita, meaning one who is protected by the Buddha. From 1948 to 1951, Venerable pursued his Dhamma studies under the eminent Buddhist scholars of the 20th century in Sri Lanka. He studied Pali and Suttas from Venerable Jnanatiloka Mahathera, Vinaya from Venerable Viduru Pola Piyatissa Mahanayaka Thera, Abhidhamma from Venerable Redukane Chandavimala Mahanayaka Thera. During this period, he had a penetrating insight into the Dharma and also developed an intense inner life full of visions and psychic experiences. His intense studies of the Tipitaka was recognized and he was conferred with the title Acharya by the Uddarata Amarapura Niyaka in Sri Lanka, normally presented to senior monks. But young Buddharakkhita accepted with great humility and vowed to work for Buddhism in India. From 1952 to 1955, Venerable studied and meditated in Burma, also known as the Golden Dhamma Land, which has preserved, protected, and promoted the Dhamma until today in its pristine purity. Venerable Acharya Buddharakkhita practiced meditation under the renowned meditation master Venerable Mahasi Syada. He studied Abhidhamma, psychology, Pathana system from Venerable Pathana Syada, and Abhidhamma from Venerable Yamaka Syada. During this time, Venerable Acharya Buddharakkhita was invited to join the Chatasangayana, the sixth Buddhist council held under the patronage of Government of Burma. He worked editing the complete Pali Tipitaka, which was published by the Government of Burma. In 1955, Venerable Acharya Buddharakkhita returned to India and taught Pali language, literature, Buddhist Psychology and Philosophy at the Nalanda Pali Postgraduate Institute.
No casualty, nothing. They were just dumped at the end somewhere, just to die. I thought that's very cruel. So there you are, that thing came. You see, there was this governor, Mr. Dhammavira, he used to come here. He had known about our work and all that. And he asked me, anything he can do? I said, I want to start a burn center. Why? Why do you want burn center? So I told him this, what I saw. Then he said, okay, I will tell some people, they will help you. They are all industrialists. And so he must have told people. They came, they said, well, how do I help you? I said, you see, I need a big hospital, at least 200-bedded hospital. So for each bed, I thought if 10,000 rupees they give and I have so many people, then the building will be there in no time. And that is what happened. I said, well, you take a bed because in your industrial facility a lot of accidents occur. So that is how it just came. In a week's time, I collected all the money and gave it to them. And then the hospital came in 3 months' time. I mean, today it's one of the best well-run facilities there. So like this, many programs came.
The Mahabodhi Arogya Hospital, Artificial Limb Center, were built to promote total health and wellness program. Thousands of artificial limbs were distributed to the poor and needy people in Karnataka. Today, in collaboration with the Malige Medical Center, the Arogya Hospital is offering ultra-modern medical facilities. He also created Bodhigram, a rural health center in Sakalwara village. In 1980, Venerable established a meditation center at Big Bear, California, USA, and also taught at the Californian University. For 20 long years, he visited USA and Europe often and brought Dhamma to the Western world. In 1992, Bante taught meditation and Buddhist philosophy at the Fukuoka University in Taiwan. In the year 2000, Venerable visited Ladakh, which lies in an altitude of 11,000 feet above sea level. Venerable was strictly advised by the doctors not to take risks going to such heights. Venerable smiled and said, "My son, there is a thing called mind over matter, and sure enough,